Pitch up on the line. LSU already up 2-0 in their best of five match play for the national championship with USC. Tigers need one more point. Ben Taylor for Eagle on 17. All square. Taylor on 18 to win the national championship. 7 feet for par. And LSU has done it. A fifth national championship. Their first in 60 years. The Tigers are national champs, and Golf Central starts now. SEC dominance continues for a third consecutive year. The SEC champion has become the national champion. Alabama the previous two seasons, and now LSU can add their name to that list for a fifth time. LSU wins the national championship. And with that, we welcome you live from the Concession Golf Club. Ryan Burr with a great cast this week. Charlie Reimer, former All-American at Georgia Tech. Gary Koch, All-American in Florida. And Buddy Alexander, who hoisted that trophy twice in his great career, a two-time national champion as the head coach at Florida. Guys, what a week, all week long. Make it 2 weeks with what the women accomplished and now the men here at the Concession Golf Club. A historic week for Golf Channel, but in the end, LSU, SEC dominance continues.
Well, it has been a great couple of weeks. We've seen some very dramatic golf. We've seen some high-quality golf. And before we get into LSU, I'd just like to offer a tip of the cap to USC coach Chris Zambry. They finished last in this championship last year. He's got that scoreboard in his office. I know that's a big reminder of that finish last year, that poor finish. And while they're not winning the national championship today, to get all the way to the championship match, really, really nice accomplishment. And ultimately, they were just outman. I think LSU had a little more depth, a little more horsepower than USC had. And great day for LSU. And it's hard for me to believe as many good players that have come out of LSU over the years that they haven't won a national title since 1955.
Yeah, I would agree, Charlie. Interestingly to me, USC, just one senior on that squad. So, you know, a very remarkable accomplishment for a young team, and certainly one that I wouldn't be surprised if we see back in a similar position here in the next couple of years. I also have to take my hat off to the Concession Golf Club. It really turned out to be a fantastic venue for both the men's and women's championships. It's in immaculate condition. It's a tough golf course. There's no question about that. But it is fair. You can hit some good shots. You can be rewarded for them. But I thought it turned out to be a marvelous golf course for match play.
Buddy? Well, I want to congratulate Chuck Winstead and his team. They'll be partying in the bayou tonight. I promise you that. I was the golf coach at LSU for 5 years, and it's a wonderful place, and I know they're going to celebrate this. And as I said earlier in the day, this is a day that Chuck will never forget, nor will these five kids.
And for all the teams out there that will try to do this next year, file this one under If You Believe. All you have to do is make it to the dance. The national champion guys found themselves 11 shots back at the regional to qualify. They shot 12 under on the final day. And just to get to the championships, they did it by one stroke. And now they're standing as the last team in the country. It's not always the best team that wins. It's the hottest team that wins. And right now, LSU Red Hot wins a fifth national championship. When you take a look at what the Tigers were able to accomplish over stroke play, conquering this golf course, and then match play, Charlie, what will you remember about LSU?
Well, I'm going to go out today to a really neat point when we had Ben Taylor at the 17th. Ben Taylor was in a spot that he was one down, sort of a critical moment, and really came up big with a big shot. And ultimately, this is a spot that I think won the day for LSU. But the fact that Stuart Jolly, their top guy, their big gun, didn't play his best golf this week, and they were still able to win this national title, to me, that says a lot about the depth of this team. To have four other guys who go out and basically take the load and hoist that national championship for the LSU Tigers.
I'm going to look to Benjamin Taylor. I mean, he did not play that well in the medal play portion of the event, and yet when it came to match play, 3-0, and twice he had, you know, clutch performances coming down the stretch there, winning matches late that could have gone the other way very easily.
And need any more proof that this game of golf is a world game? The man that secures the winning point for LSU is from London, England, Benjamin Taylor, the hero, with an eagle at 17, a clutch par save at 18 to win the hole. He's standing by with Angela Heyman.
Ryan, I am with the man of the hour, Ben Taylor from LSU. Ben, you just made the clutch par in 18 to win the national championship for your Tigers. What was going through your mind as you stood over that putt?
Well, At first, on the birdie putt, we knew that a two putt was likely to be good enough to win the national championship. It was obviously a very fast putt, which I left short. But I mean, I had that putt in the practice round, that 10 foot down the hill. So we knew the line. I just had to put a good stroke on it. And I mean, it was perfect. It was a perfect moment to a perfect college career. And you know, I couldn't be more happy. I'm emotional. I don't really know what to say. But it's been a great day, and what a finish to my college career. So happy.
Well, congratulations on this awesome day for you, Ben.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
You know, Ben Taylor and Zach Wright were unbeatable this week. Literally, you take a look at the numbers, you wonder how LSU was able to win their fifth national championship. Look no further than Ben Taylor and Zach Wright, a combined 6-0 in match play. They trailed for a total of 17 holes, and just two matches made it all the way to 18. Ben Taylor, Zach Wright were match play ninjas this week for the LSU Tigers. As we get into the highlights, Charlie, give me your key shots.
Well, just mention it. Now we're going to have a chance to look at it. That second shot for Ben Taylor out at 17, the par 5. This match was one down, and I really needed to have something special happen, and he did. He played a heck of a shot, and Bobby Gawanko ended up making birdie here, but Ben Taylor with this shot ultimately let him be able to put this in close, win the hole, and he would go on and win 18 with a solid par. But this is just a really key moment right here. I mean, when you look back on this championship match, he's going to remember this shot, putting it in there close, and ultimately this was the shot and the hole, I think, that LSU can point to in sealing the deal on this national title.
And Gary, to your point about the concession golf club, a chance to make eagle at 17. We saw a lot of eagle chances this week.
Well, we did, and just a really well-designed golf course, I think, with you know, some risk-reward holes coming down the stretch, 15, 16, 17, water in play, and then 18, just a very difficult par 4, which here we saw Ben Taylor, Charlie, make the putt that mattered.
Put the ball in the middle of the green, hit a pretty decent approach putt, but that was a sweet moment, and was not an easy putt either. I mean, feeling the nerves downhill, sliding a little bit left to right, that's a tough one. I love the reaction of his teammates running up, kind of jump right in on that 18th green, and what an amazing feeling right there that has to be for those young student athletes.
So the big timer jumping in here with Ben Taylor, not going out on a limb with the guy that clinches the match, eagle at 17.
Well, he's the senior guy on this
winning putt on 18.
We're going to ask these guys to give us some key moments,
big timer. What do you got, Gary?
Well, I've got Zach Wright. Now, my guy hit a phenomenal second shot. He's two up in the match as he goes to 16, and he hits a drive to the right, which is safe. It's right of the water. But off the pine straw, watch this second shot. Controls the distance beautifully. He's two up in the match at this time. He would go on to make that putt to close out his match 3-2. And Charlie, my guy gets the second point, which then puts your guy in a position to be able to clinch it.
Well, I hear you, but I still like my guy.
Well, but my guy is now 5-0-0 in his NCAA match play career.
Actually, 6-0.
No, he's 5-0.
3-0 last year. Patrick Reed, 6-0.
Well, that's where I was trying to go. There's only one other player with a better record.
But who got the clinching putt?
But who set the guy up to get the clinching
putt? Yeah, but the guy got the clinching putt.
Coach,
help us, coach.
Settle down.
Come on, coach. Jump in here for us, would you?
Oh, my shot of the day?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, you guys
didn't
leave any good material. I'll take a coach's point of view here and not necessarily pick a shot. I'm going to pick a decision. On the 12th tee, Rico Hoy was one down, and he hit a driver off the deck. I thought that was a very peculiar decision, and he ended up hitting it in the front right bunker, which left a very difficult up and down. He would lose that hole, go on to lose the next hole, number 13, and put himself in a pretty tough position. And then at the 17th hole, Brandon Pierce hold this putt to win the match and get the first point on the board for LSU.
So let's take a look at the full results. Once again, LSU able to win a fifth national championship. They actually surpass a tie with Florida now as the most golf championships in the SEC, as they now have 5, Florida with the 4 national championships. But SEC dominance, guys, it is clear. We hear a lot about it in football until Ohio State was able to break through this year on the gridiron as the Buckeyes win the national championship. There is clearly an SEC dominance as well. I know you two are pretty proud of that as they win now a third consecutive, the SEC national championship on the golf course. Buddy?
Well, it's a tough league. Always has been.
Yeah.
It was tough when Gary played, and it still is. There has been a little recent dominance, but
you know, those things are cyclical, and it'll come around and go around a little bit. But, yeah, they've certainly done well in the last couple of years.
Yeah, and I think a lot of it has to do with, as you say, buddy, a lot of good teams, so they're constantly playing against good competition. And, you know, LSU was fortunate enough to win the SEC championship, but there were some other teams that were here that didn't, but yet still made it all this way. So when you're playing against good competition virtually week after week after week, it toughens you up.
Well, you know what? The SEC obviously has a momentum, but there's a lot of great golf programs out there. And big thank you to all the folks at all these schools that are very supportive of these golf programs, because folks like us wouldn't have had the opportunity that we've had to play this game without the supporters of these schools that come in and help fund these golf programs. So there's a lot of key folks, a lot of key stakeholders that support college golf, and we're all grateful for that, and we all are winners because of that.
Coach Alexander, you mentioned the party on the Bayou. It's been some time since they've been able to celebrate a golf national championship. How about 60 years to be exact, as indeed it is the longest drought in NCAA history. Stanford 41 years before, Texas 40 years, Ohio State 34 years, but LSU 1955 to 2015 with no titles in between. LSU wins their fifth national championship. When we come back on Golf Central live from the national championship, we turn our attention to the runner-up. USC doesn't win their first ever national championship, but with only one senior, they're in great position, plus much more celebration from LSU. You're watching Golf Central live from the national championship.
Golf Central, brought to you by the new Titleist 915 drivers, introducing distance without compromise. Fidelity Investments.
Welcome back. We are live at the national championship from Bradenton, Florida. USC has still never won a national championship in men's golf in 56 appearances, but they did clinch their best ever finish in program history with the second place performance this week. Angela Heyman, as we take a look at the scores here, as LSU came out and pretty dominant from the get-go. Early on, they were able to take care of business as Hoey, you had to feel straight out of the gate was a great chance for USC to jump up and get a point over Pierce, but it's Pierce winning 2-1. Taylor, we showed you with the clutch shot on 17 and 18, and ultimately Wright taking care of business once again, 3-2. Angela Heyman now with USC head coach Chris Zambry.
Coach Zambry, I know that this is a tough day for you after this match, after losing in the finals. What are your overall thoughts of the final match?
I really was only looking at one match all day. I got to see a little of Rico in front and a little of Sean behind, but really concentrated on Bobby's match. It was really up and down match. There was some good golf. There was some not so good golf. But a lot of good stuff happened at the end. You know, Bobby just hit a bad drive on the last and ended up putting himself in a bad way to make par.
Well, you have a young team when you look at it. You only have one senior on the team. How proud are you of the way that Sugimoto played the whole week? And then what do you look forward to with these guys coming back?
So proud of Eric to be able to go out the way he did in college golf. I mean, he can only look back with good memories, especially of this week. For the rest of the guys, I just want them to practice hard and get better. And, you know, I don't know exactly how we played today. It didn't look great. And so there's always room to get better, and that's what I want them to do.
Well, regardless, this has been a very successful week for your team. What is the biggest takeaway from this week?
Biggest takeaway is we had the best week in the history of our program at this tournament. And these guys have to have confidence next year. And hopefully they have a taste of what it's like and will be hungrier next year than they were this year. And hopefully we can get it done.
Well, Coach, congratulations on a very successful season.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
And with LSU defeating USC, the Pac-12 falls to 0-4 versus SEC programs in NCAA match play since 2009, as once again it is an SEC school beating a Pac-12 school in match play. As LSU gets in line, they did it back in 2014, and Alabama, of course, in Arkansas with success in 2012 and 2009. All weekend long, Steve Rakowski has been a huge part of our broadcast as our college insider on the broadcast. He's joined now by Noda Begay, and I'm curious to hear both of your perspectives as LSU kind of comes out of nowhere, barely gets through the regional guys, but in the end, they're standing there as national champions.
Well, Ryan, when you think about what happened at the regionals a couple weeks ago at Yale, five teams from each of the six regional sites qualify for the championship here at the Concession Golf Club. And heading into that last day, they were in 10th place, 11 shots off the magic number. They rallied hard down the stretch, got the final spot by a single shot. So that's maybe somewhat of the surprising part that they were able to figure out Yale after 2 days of struggles. But in terms of coming out of nowhere, without question, no. That's simple. LSU is really, really good. They won the SEC championship first time since 1987. And Noda, when you think about what LSU did in conferences, had a battle against at regionals, how much do you think that helped them here when their backs were against the wall?
Well, it was so much about momentum, I think, because a team that was up against the wall, they fought their way back, dug themselves out of a hole, and felt like they had a new lease on life coming into this event, and then played so well to get into the match play portion, and then just felt like they were working on sort of borrowed time almost, in the sense they just went out, and they really executed, and they relied on a couple key players, and I think that's the biggest thing with this match play format. If you can get two key players to kick in and be the cornerstone of your success, then your other players kind of build off of that, and that's exactly what they had this week.
Well, Zach Wright, a perfect 5-0, the last two NCAA championships, but Chuck Winstead, their coach, telling us all week long, they're all interchangeable. Their stroke averages throughout the course of the season, just over about one shot difference between all five of them. You've played on very talented and deep teams. When you know the guy in front of you or the guy behind you is going to help you out, how much does that ease them, especially in this match play format?
Well, it also creates a sense of chemistry and a team mentality. With us, our big guy was Tiger Woods. With Arizona State, it was Phil Mickelson. And with a lot of these teams, they try and rely maybe a little bit too much on their marquee players. With these particular teams that got to the finals, there was no real marquee players. Only two of the players were ranked in the top 50 in the golf stat rankings. So they had to spread the workload out, and these guys were playing for each other, pulling for each other, and there was no sort of real superstar on the team, and it was reflective in how they came together when it mattered most.
Chuck Winstead, the coach at LSU, been there for a decade, told me he didn't have to go coach LSU. He wanted to, because this school meant everything to them. When you have a guy running the ship like that, that has given his heart and soul, how much could you expect that maybe this would almost happen one day?
Well, he also has a great ability to judge talent. You saw USC, all their players are from California. Georgia, all of their players were from the state of Georgia. But he did go out of the state, got one from Phoenix, and went all the way across the pond to bring in one from England. And I think that's a trend that we're going to see in coaches scouring the corners of the globe. We had eight countries other than the United States represented in this year's field. 19 of the 30 teams had an international player on their squad. So I think that's one thing that coaches are going to try and focus on, is there's so much saturation of talent in the United States that they're going to start looking for other places to sort of find some talent that they can develop.
Well, they certainly developed some talent in LSU this past year. It's been a lot of fun throughout the week. Appreciate it.
I had always such a great time. They played so well.
First national championship in 60 years for the LSU men's golf program. It is their fifth overall, a jubilant Tiger group. Heading to our Golf Central set, we'll hear from the newest national champions right after this.
For us, this is our major.
Our teammates are like brothers.
Our coaches are like parents.
We work hard all year for this moment. Yeah! And after six long, hard days of golf,
tense moments and much celebration,
we walk proud.
We did it. Brandon Pierce,
Eric Ricard,
Zach Wright, Stuart Jolly,
Ben Taylor.
We are the 2015 NCAA National Champions.
What started with 30 is down to one. LSU stands atop the golfing world as national champion. Their first time in 60 years that they win a national championship, and there have been some changes since the last time LSU was able to hold that trophy high. In particular, I'd like to go back to that gasoline cost in 1955, 23 cents a gallon, the last time LSU stood supreme of the golfing world. We are lucky enough and proud enough to welcome the LSU Tigers onto our set here at Golf Central. They brought the trophy with them. And guys, first of all, congratulations. It's been an unbelievable journey all the way from regionals, where you found yourselves 11 shots down, fight your way into the NCAAs, and now stand here as national champion. So, guys, introduce yourself. Tell us where you're from.
Zach Wright. I'm from Phoenix, Arizona, and I'm a junior.
I'm Eric Ricard. I'm a sophomore, and I'm from Shreveport, Louisiana.
I'm Brandon Pierce. I'm a sophomore, and I'm from Covington, Louisiana.
I'm Stuart Jolly. I graduated 3 weeks ago, and I'm from Birmingham, Alabama.
I'm Ben Taylor. I just graduated also, and I'm from England.
Garrett Runyon, assistant coach. This is my third year.
And Coach Winstead, Chuck Winstead, you've been there how long?
It's my 10th year.
The 10th year, and we just saw it's the first national championship in 60 years. Give me an idea of the emotions that are running through your body now that this group was able to get you to the promised land.
Well, you know, there are a lot of people at LSU that care about men's golf and really the athletic department. I mean, so, you know, having graduated from LSU and being a Tiger, you know, it's very special.
For Benjamin and Zach, a perfect 6-0 this week in match play. You guys really carried the club, refused to lose, if you will. Did you think this was possible?
Obviously, yes. I mean, we came here on a mission to try to win this.
Match play, the last 2 years, you've gone undefeated. Is there something about match play that seems to make you play your best golf?
Absolutely. I mean, I could be more aggressive, so it definitely, there's not a fear of losing, like, because you only lose one hole, we don't lose multiple strokes to the field.
Let's talk to Ben. Ben, obviously, you're going to be that shot on 17 is the shot we're going to see for years to come. You make eagle there, and you were down in your match. Tell me on 17, that second shot, how were the nerves?
Surprisingly, not too bad. Before I hit my shot, coach asked me, "You having fun?" And it's hard to say no because it was a lot of fun. And it was a perfect club, perfect yardage, and we knew it was going to be a good shot. It was destiny. I mean, we worked too hard all year, and to see it run up that tier and go to the back of that green by that back pin was pretty special, and it was a great way to end a great match.
Stuart, you're a senior. Obviously, this will be the last time you get to stand here with these guys and play in a golf tournament, and you go out at the absolute tops. You take home the 43rd national championship to LSU. A school that is so proud of their athletics. As a senior, your last time with these guys on the field of battle, what is this week, what do these couple weeks mean to you?
It means a lot. I mean, I'm out there playing with my brothers, and just couldn't be more proud of them. This is where we work for all year long. We've worked so hard for this. The semifinals last year definitely stung a bit, and came out here with a chip on our shoulder and got it done this year.
SEC wins their third national championship in a row. What is it about this conference that seems to prepare the teams for to get here to match play, to get here when the competition is its stiffest?
The SEC is just very competitive. There are a lot of great players and a lot of great players that want to come play for the SEC. So it's just really challenging, and it's great.
Coach, what do you think this means to LSU? What does this mean to the faculty of the athletic department to bring home not just a trophy but a national championship?
Well, the supporters at LSU as well as the administration have supported us for these 10 years. We didn't do this by ourselves, and you know, so I think it means quite a lot. They've invested. I mean, I'm just so proud of these guys. You know, I mean, it's hard to get in a position to even have a chance to win this tournament, and then when you show up out here today and you still have the resolve to play the way they did, I'm very proud of them.
In 60 years, when they show a picture of you guys holding a trophy like we've seen with the last LSU team, what do you want the people to remember about what this squad was able to do in 2015?
That's a good question. I mean, I'm just proud of the fact that from my perspective, they just continue to improve. That's really our mainstay. That's where we go. I mean, from where we begin to where we end, we just always want to improve. And a lot, these guys, they hear it a lot, but I mean, that's really all I feel like you can control. I mean, if you're constantly trying to chip away at the small things and continue to improve, then whatever the results are, you can live with.
Who wants to tell me just how tough this golf course was? Because on television, it looked like a monster. How tough was it, guys?
Very hard.
Yes, yeah, difficult. Very hard.
Well, you guys will be on Morning Drive tomorrow, so the media tour will continue because there's only one national champion, and it is you guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Once again. Stood up and took on a great test this week. Congratulations, and enjoy it, boys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Go Tigers.
Go Tigers.
So once again, LSU wins their fifth national championship. The Tigers bring home their 43rd national championship to the campus of LSU. LSU reigns atop the college golf world, and Zach Wright, a huge part of that. Here he is, his second on 16 from the Pine Straw. And Wright continues to be Wright, as he was all week. 6 feet, he'd go on to win his match. LSU wins the national title. Find out what gave them the edge next. For the first time since 1955, LSU wins the national championship in men's golf. It is time now for the Comcast Business Edge. And Coach Alexander, LSU, what gave them the edge this week to stand on top of the golf world?
I just think they had the it factor. They were able to play great golf when it mattered most, when the situation was special and they had to come up with a great shot or win a match. They just did it, and that's what winners do. I mean, go back to the regional where they had their backs up against the wall. That was a special golf round there, and then this week they just kind of carried that it factor with them all week long.
And, Buddy, you know, you talk about some of those crucial shots at the right time. Well, Benjamin Taylor, to me, was the guy who produced two of the most spectacular ones that we saw yesterday on the 18th hole. You know, he's got the match right there. They're all square. He produces this second shot at the long par four. Middle iron. Hole is in the back left portion of the green. He utilizes the slope perfectly, runs the ball right back down by the hole, and ends up winning the hole in the match. Now, this is a guy that shot 23 over par in the 72-hole stroke play portion of this event. He finished plus, you know, at 311 was the total, and then he hits this second shot today. He's one down, second shot at the par 5, 17th, another kind of long iron. And this one goes right up by the hole, ends up making this putt for an eagle. So how would you ever have expected a man who shot 23 over par for the 72 holes to go 3-0-0 in the match play?
And that's really the key for me, because this team, in spite of going out on this really challenging golf course and having some ugly things happen to them, it's not like they went out and played perfect golf. And so many times when a team wins a big championship or a golfer wins a big championship, you think, oh, they were perfect the entire week. That's not the case. But what they were so good at is dealing with the bad stuff. LSU was able to deal with the bad stuff, put it behind them, and that's what allowed them to come up big when they need it the most.
And guys, we've seen in every sport, in a championship, some guys want the ball when the game's on the line, others don't. LSU had several players, including Benjamin Taylor and Zach Wright, that when the game was on the line in match play, those guys went undefeated. They had the it factor, and the SEC has had the it factor the last 3 years, as Alabama's won the last two, and now LSU adds their name to that list. So a great football rivalry with LSU and Alabama. They've now won the last three NCAA championships in men's golf, and that is our Comcast Business Edge. So USC comes up a one match short, but still is their best finish ever in the national championships, their best finish ever in school history. They've made 56 appearances at the NCAAs, but this obviously their best finish as you take a look at the Pac-12 over the years and exactly how they've done. Angela Heyman now with more on USC's great run.
Well, Eric, I know that this is tough for you. You're a little bit emotional. That's very understandable. But what positives can you take away from this awesome experience with your teammates here this week?
Well, it was a great season, you know. Nobody expected us to come here, and we believed in ourselves. You know, we showcased the talent that we have, and I think we achieved, you know, better than what we thought we would. You know, there's a ton of positives that come out of this. You know, all the guys, the four guys remaining here, coming back next year, you know, they have something to focus on, and they know how it feels, and they know how to play, and I think it's really, really great.
As the senior on this team, you've been through a little bit more than some of the underclassmen. What will your exiting remarks be to these guys after such an amazing season?
I love them. I mean, I'm just proud of them. You know, I love them. If they ever need anything, I'm there for them. You know, I'm a happy guy. You know, I couldn't ask for more.
Well, congratulations on an awesome season, Eric.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
LSU has already put their winning touch on the national championship trophy. And when we return the last 2 weeks here at the Concession Golf Club, it has been something special. We relive the magic next. that shot on 17 is the shot we're going to see for years to come. You make eagle there, and you were down in your match. Tell me on 17, that second shot, how were the nerves?
Surprisingly, not too bad. Before I hit my shot, coach asked me, "You having fun?" And it's hard to say no because it was a lot of fun. And it was a perfect club, perfect yardage. And I mean, we knew it was going to be a good shot. It was destiny. I mean, we worked too hard all year, and to see it run up that tier and go to the back of that green by that back pin was pretty special. And it was a great way to end a great match.
Stuart, you're a senior. Obviously, this will be the last time you get to stand here with these guys and play in a golf tournament, and you go out at the absolute tops. You take home the 43rd national championship to LSU, a school that is so proud of their athletics. As a senior, your last time with these guys on the field of battle, what is this week, what do these couple weeks mean to you?
It means a lot. I mean, I'm out there playing with my brothers, and just couldn't be more proud of them. This is where we work for all year long. We've worked so hard for this. The semifinals last year definitely stung a bit, and came out here with a chip on our shoulder and got it done this year.
SEC wins their third national championship in a row. What is it about this conference that seems to prepare the teams for to get here to match play, to get here when the competition is its stiffest?
The SEC is just very competitive. There are a lot of great players and a lot of great players that want to come play for the SEC. So it's just really challenging, and it's great.
Coach, what do you think this means to LSU? What does this mean to the faculty of the athletic department to bring home not just a trophy but a national championship?
Well, the supporters at LSU as well as the administration have supported us for these 10 years. We didn't do this by ourselves, and you know, so I think it means quite a lot. They've invested. I mean, I'm just so proud of these guys. You know, I mean, it's hard to get in a position to even have a chance to win this tournament, and then when you show up out here today and you still have the resolve to play the way they did, I'm very proud of them.
In 60 years, when they show a picture of you guys holding a trophy like we've seen with the last LSU team, what do you want the people to remember about what this squad was able to do in 2015?
That's a good question. I mean, I'm just proud of the fact that from my perspective, they just continue to improve. That's really our mainstay. That's where we go. I mean, from where we begin to where we end, we just always want to improve. And a lot, these guys, they hear it a lot, but I mean, that's really all I feel like you can control. I mean, if you're constantly trying to chip away at the small things and continue to improve, then whatever the results are, you can live with.
Who wants to tell me just how tough this golf course was? Because on television, it looked like a monster. How tough was it, guys?
Very hard.
Yeah, it was very hard.
Well, you guys will be on Morning Drive tomorrow, so the media tour will continue because there's only one national champion, and it is you guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Once again. Stood up and took on a great test this week. Congratulations, and enjoy it, boys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Go Tigers.
Go Tigers.
So once again, LSU wins their fifth national championship. The Tigers bring home their 43rd national championship to the campus of LSU. LSU reigns atop the college golf world, and Zach Wright, a huge part of that. Here he is, his second on 16 from the Pine Straw. And Wright continues to be Wright, as he was all week. 6 feet, he'd go on to win his match. LSU wins the national title. Find out what gave them the edge next. For the first time since 1955, LSU wins the national championship in men's golf. It is time now for the Comcast Business Edge. And Coach Alexander, LSU, what gave them the edge this week to stand on top of the golf world?
I just think they had the it factor. They were able to play great golf when it mattered most, when the situation was special and they had to come up with a great shot or win a match. They just did it, and that's what winners do. I mean, go back to the regional where they had their backs up against the wall. That was a special golf round there. And then this week, they just kind of carried that it factor with them all week long.
And, Buddy, you know, you talk about some of those crucial shots at the right time. Well, Benjamin Taylor to me was the guy who produced two of the most spectacular ones that we saw yesterday on the 18th hole. You know, he's got the match right there. They're all.
It's been a great day, and what a finish to my college career. So happy.
Well, congratulations on this awesome day for you, Ben.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
You know, Ben Taylor and Zach Wright were unbeatable this week. Literally, you take a look at the numbers, you wonder how LSU was able to win their fifth national championship. Look no further than Ben Taylor and Zach Wright, a combined 6-0 in match play. They trailed for a total of 17 holes, and just two matches made it all the way to 18. Ben Taylor, Zach Wright were match play ninjas this week for the LSU Tigers. As we get into the highlights, Charlie, give me your key shots.
Well, just mention it. Now we're going to have a chance to look at it. That second shot for Ben Taylor out at 17, the par 5. This match was one down, and I really needed to have something special happen, and he did. He played a heck of a shot, and Bobby Gawanko ended up making birdie here, but Ben Taylor with this shot ultimately let him be able to put this in close, win the hole, and he would go on and win 18 with a solid par. But this is just a really key moment right here. I mean, when you look back on this championship match, he's going to remember this shot, putting it in there close, and ultimately this was the shot and the hole, I think, that LSU can point to in sealing the deal on this national title.
And Gary, to your point about the concession golf club, a chance to make eagle at 17. We saw a lot of eagle chances this week.
Well, we did, and just a really well-designed golf course, I think, with you know, some risk-reward holes coming down the stretch, 15, 16, 17, water in play, and then 18, just a very difficult par 4, which here we saw Ben Taylor, Charlie, make the putt that mattered.
Put the ball in the middle of the green, a pretty decent approach putt, but that was a sweet moment, and was not an easy putt either. I mean, feeling the nerves downhill, sliding a little bit left to right, that's a tough one. I love the reaction of his teammates running up, kind of jump right in on that 18th green, and what an amazing feeling right there that has to be for those young student athletes.
So the big timer jumping in here with Ben Taylor, not going out on a limb with the guy that clinches the match, eagle at 17.
Well, he's the senior guy on this
winning
set.
Putt on 18.
We're gonna ask these guys to give us some key moments, big timer. What do you got, Gary?
Well, I've got Zach Wright. Now, my guy hit a phenomenal second shot. He's two up in the match as he goes to 16, and he hits a drive to the right, which is safe. It's right of the water, but off the pine straw. Watch this second shot. Controls the distance beautifully. He's two up in the match at this time. He would go on to make that putt to close out his match 3-2. And Charlie, my guy gets the second point, which then puts your guy in a position to be able to clinch it.
I hear you, but I still like my guy.
Well, but my guy is now 5-0-0 in his NCAA match play career.
Actually, 6-0.
No, he's 5-0.
3-0 last year. Patrick Reed, 6-0.
Well, that's where I was trying to go.
Yeah, go ahead.
And there's only one other player with a better record.
But who got the clinching putt?
But who set the guy up to get the clinching
putt? Yeah, but the guy got the clinching putt.
Coach,
help us, coach.
Settle down.
Come on, coach. Jump in here for us, would you?
Oh, my shot of the day?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, you guys didn't leave any good material. I'll take a coach's point of view here and not necessarily pick a shot. I'm going to pick a decision. On the 12th tee, Rico Hoy was one down, and he hit a driver off the deck. I thought that was a very peculiar decision, and he ended up hitting it in the front right bunker, which left a very difficult up and down. He would lose that hole, go on to lose the next hole, number 13, and put himself in a pretty tough position. And then at the 17th hole, Brandon Pierce hold this putt to win the match and get the first point on the board for LSU.
So let's take a look at the full results. Once again, LSU able to win a fifth national championship. They actually surpass a tie with Florida now as the most golf championships in the SEC, as they now have 5, Florida with the 4 national championships. But SEC dominance, guys, it is clear. We hear a lot about it in football until Ohio State was able to break through this year on the gridiron as the Buckeyes win the national championship. There is clearly an SEC dominance as well. I know you two are pretty proud of that as they win now a third consecutive, the SEC national championship on the golf course. Buddy?
Well, it's a tough league. Always has been.
Yeah.
It was tough when Gary played, and it still is. There has been a little recent dominance, but you know, those things are cyclical, and it'll come around and go around a little bit. But, yeah, they've certainly done well in the last couple of years.
Yeah, and I think a lot of it has to do with, as you say, buddy, a lot of good teams, so they're constantly playing against good competition. And, you know, LSU was fortunate enough to win the SEC championship, but there were some other teams that were here that didn't, but yet still made it all this way. So when you're playing against good competition virtually week after week after week, it toughens you up.
Well, you know what? The SEC obviously has a momentum, but there's a lot of great golf programs out there. And big thank you to all the folks at all these schools that are very supportive of these golf programs, because folks like us wouldn't have had the opportunity that we've had to play this game without the support.
I think that's the biggest thing with this match play format. If you can get two key players to kick in and be the cornerstone of your success, then your other players kind of build off of that, and that's exactly what they had this week.
Well, Zach Wright, a perfect 5-0 the last two NCAA championships, but Chuck Winstead, their coach, telling us all week long, they're all interchangeable. Their stroke averages throughout the course of the season, just over about one shot difference between all five of them. You've played on very talented and deep teams. When you know the guy in front of you or the guy behind you is going to help you out, how much does that ease them, especially in this match play format?
Well, it also creates a sense of chemistry and a team mentality. With us, our big guy was Tiger Woods. With Arizona State, it was Phil Mickelson. And with a lot of these teams, they try and rely maybe a little bit too much on their marquee players. With these particular teams that got to the finals, there was no real marquee players. Only two of the players were ranked in the top 50 in the golf stat rankings, so they had to spread the workload out, and these guys were playing for each other, pulling for each other, and there was no sort of real superstar on the team, and it was reflective in how they came together when it mattered most.
Chuck Winstead, the coach at LSU, been there for a decade, told me he didn't have to go coach LSU. He wanted to, because this school meant everything to them. When you have a guy running the ship like that, that has given his heart and soul, how much could you expect that maybe this would almost happen one day?
Well, he also has a great ability to judge talent. You saw USC, all their players are from California. Georgia, all of their players were from the state of Georgia. But he did go out of the state, got one from Phoenix, and went all the way across the pond to bring in one from England. And I think that's a trend that we're going to see in coaches scouring the corners of the globe. We had 8 countries other than the United States represented in this year's field. 19 of the 30 teams had an international player on their squad. So I think that's one thing that coaches are going to try and focus on, is there's so much saturation of talent in the United States that they're going to start looking for other places to sort of find some talent that they can develop.
Well, they certainly developed some talent in LSU this past year. It's been a lot of fun throughout the week. Appreciate it as
always.
I had
such a great time. They played so well.
First national championship in 60 years for the LSU men's golf program. It is their 5th overall, a jubilant Tiger group. Heading to our Golf Central set, we'll hear from the newest national champions right after this.
For us, this is our major.
Our teammates are like brothers.
Our coaches are like parents.
We work hard all year for this moment.
Yeah!
And after 6 long, hard days of golf,
tense moments and much celebration,
we walk proud.
We did it. Brandon Pierce,
Eric Ricard,
Zach Wright, Stuart Jolly,
Ben Taylor.
We are the 2015 NCAA National Champions.
What started with 30 is down to 1. LSU stands atop the golfing world as national champion. Their first time in 60 years that they win a national championship, and there have been some changes since the last time LSU was able to hold that trophy high. In particular, I'd like to go back to that gasoline cost in 1955, 23 cents a gallon, the last time LSU stood supreme of the golfing world. We are lucky enough and proud enough to welcome the LSU Tigers onto our set here at Golf Central. They brought the trophy with them. And guys, first of all, congratulations. It's been an unbelievable journey all the way from regionals, where you found yourselves 11 shots down, fight your way into the NCAAs, and now stand here as national champion. So, guys, introduce yourself. Tell us where you're from.
Zach Wright. I'm from Phoenix, Arizona, and I'm a junior.
I'm Eric Ricard. I'm a sophomore, and I'm from Shreveport, Louisiana.
I'm Brandon Pierce. I'm a sophomore, and I'm from Covington, Louisiana.
I'm Stuart Jolly. I graduated 3 weeks ago, and I'm from Birmingham, Alabama.
I'm Ben Taylor. I just graduated also, and I'm from England.
Garrett Runyon, assistant coach. This is my 3rd year.
And Coach Winstead, Chuck Winstead, you've been there how long?
It's my 10th year.
The 10th year, and we just saw it's the first national championship in 60 years. Give me an idea of the emotions that are running through your body now that this group was able to get you to the promised land.
Well, you know, there are a lot of people at LSU that care about men's golf and really the athletic department. I mean, so, you know, having graduated from LSU and being a Tiger, you know, it's very special.
For Benjamin and Zach, a perfect 6-0 this week in match play. You guys really carried the club, refused to lose, if you will. Did you think this was possible?
Obviously, yes. I mean, we came here on a mission to try to win this.
Match play, the last 2 years, you've gone undefeated. Is there something about match play that seems to make you play your best golf?
Absolutely. I mean, I can be more aggressive, so it definitely, there's not a fear of losing, like, because you only lose one hole. We don't lose multiple strokes to the field.
Let's talk to Ben. Ben, obviously, you're going to be the championship on the line. LSU already up 2-0 in their best of five match play for the national championship with USC. Tigers need one more point. Ben Taylor for Eagle on 17, all square. Taylor on 18 to win the national championship, 7 feet for par, and LSU has done it. A fifth national championship, their first in 60 years. The Tigers are national champs, and Golf Central starts now. SEC dominance continues. For a third consecutive year, the SEC champion has become the national champion. Alabama the previous two seasons, and now LSU can add their name to that list for a fifth time. LSU wins the national championship. And with that, we welcome you live from the Concession Golf Club. Ryan Burr with a great cast this week. Charlie Reimer, former All-American at Georgia Tech. Gary Koch, All-American in Florida. And Buddy Alexander, who hoisted that trophy twice in his great career, a two-time national champion as the head coach at Florida. Guys, what a week, all week long. Make it 2 weeks with what the women accomplished and now the men here at the Concession Golf Club. A historic week for Golf Channel, but in the end, LSU, SEC dominance continues.
Well, it has been a great couple of weeks. We've seen some very dramatic golf. We've seen some high-quality golf. And before we get into LSU, I'd just like to offer a tip of the cap to USC coach Chris Zambry. They finished last in this championship last year. He's got that scoreboard in his office. I know that's a big reminder of that finish last year, that poor finish. And while they're not winning the national championship today, to get all the way to the championship match, really, really nice accomplishment. And ultimately, they were just outman. I think LSU had a little more depth, a little more horsepower than USC had. And great day for LSU. And it's hard for me to believe, as many good players that have come out of LSU over the years, that they haven't won a national title since 1955.
Yeah, I would agree, Charlie. Interestingly to me, USC, just one senior on that squad. So, you know, a very remarkable accomplishment for a young team, and certainly one that I wouldn't be surprised if we see back in a similar position here in the next couple of years. I also have to take my hat off to the Concession Golf Club. It really turned out to be a fantastic venue for both the men's and women's championships. It's in immaculate condition. It's a tough golf course. There's no question about that. But it is fair. You can hit some good shots. You can be rewarded for them. But I thought it turned out to be a marvelous golf course for match play.
Buddy?
Well, I want to congratulate Chuck Winstead and his team. They'll be partying in the bayou tonight, I promise you that. I was the golf coach at LSU for 5 years, and it's a wonderful place, and I know they're going to celebrate this. And as I said earlier in the day, this is a day that Chuck will never forget, nor will these five kids.
And for all the teams out there that will try to do this next year, file this one under If You Believe. All you have to do is make it to the dance. The national champion guys found themselves 11 shots back at the regional to qualify. They shot 12 under on the final day. And just to get to the championships, they did it by one stroke. And now they're standing as the last team in the country. It's not always the best team that wins. It's the hottest team that wins. And right now, LSU Red Hot wins a fifth national championship. When you take a look at what the Tigers were able to accomplish over stroke play, conquering this golf course, and then match play, Charlie. What will you remember about LSU?
Well, I'm going to go out today to a really neat point when we had Ben Taylor at the 17th. Ben Taylor was in a spot that he was one down, sort of a critical moment, and really came up big with a big shot. And ultimately, this is a spot that I think won the day for LSU. But the fact that Stuart Jolly, their top guy, their big gun, didn't play his best golf this week, and they were still able to win this national title, to me, that says a lot about the depth of this team. To have four other guys who go out and basically take the load and hoist that national championship for the LSU Tigers.
I'm going to look to Benjamin Taylor. I mean, he did not play that well in the medal play portion of the event, and yet when it came to match play, 3-0, and twice he had, you know, clutch performances coming down the stretch there, winning matches late that could have gone the other way very easily.
And need any more proof that this game of golf is a world game? The man that secures the winning point for LSU is from London, England, Benjamin Taylor, the hero, with an eagle at 17, a clutch par save at 18 to win the hole. He's standing by with Angela Heyman.
Ryan, I am with the man of the hour, Ben Taylor from LSU. Ben, you just made the clutch par in 18 to win the national championship for your Tigers. What was going through your mind as you stood over that putt?
Well, at first on the birdie putt, we knew that a two putt was likely to be good enough to win the national championship. It was obviously a very fast putt, which I left short. But I mean, I had that putt in the practice round, that 10 foot down the hill. So we knew the line. I just had to put a good stroke on it. And I mean, it was perfect. It was a perfect moment to a perfect college career, and you know, I couldn't be more happy. I'm emotional. I don't really know what to say, but it's
quarters of these schools that come in and help fund these golf programs. So there's a lot of key folks, a lot of key stakeholders that support college golf, and we're all grateful for that. And we all are winners because of that.
Coach Alexander, you mentioned the party on the Bayou. It's been some time since they've been able to celebrate a golf national championship. How about 60 years to be exact? As indeed, it is the longest drought in NCAA history. Stanford 41 years before, Texas 40 years, Ohio State 34 years, but LSU 1955 to 2015 with no titles in between. LSU wins their fifth national championship. When we come back on Golf Central live from the national championship, we turn our attention to the runner-up. USC doesn't win their first ever national championship, but with only one senior, they're in great position, plus much more celebration from LSU. You're watching Golf Central live from the national championship.
Golf Central, brought to you by the new Titleist 915 drivers, introducing distance without compromise. Fidelity Investments.
Welcome back. We are live at the national championship from Bradenton, Florida. USC has still never won a national championship in men's golf in 56 appearances, but they did clinch their best ever finish in program history with the second place performance this week. Angela Heyman, as we take a look at the scores here, as LSU came out and pretty dominant from the get-go. Early on, they were able to take care of business as Hoey, you had to feel straight out of the gate, was a great chance for USC to jump up and get a point over Pierce, but it's Pierce winning 2-1. Taylor, we showed you with the clutch shot on 17 and 18, and ultimately Wright taking care of business once again, 3-2. Angela Heyman now with USC head coach Chris Zambry.
Coach Zambry, I know that this is a tough day for you after this match, after losing in the finals. What are your overall thoughts of the final match?
I really was only looking at one match all day. I got to see a little of Rico in front and a little of Sean behind, but really concentrated on Bobby's match. It was really up and down match. There was some good golf. There was some not so good golf. But a lot of good stuff happened at the end. You know, Bobby just hit a bad drive on the last and ended up putting himself in a bad way to make par.
Well, you have a young team when you look at it. You only have one senior on the team. How proud are you of the way that Sugimoto played the whole week? And then what do you look forward to with these guys coming back?
So proud of Eric to be able to go out the way he did in college golf. I mean, he can only look back with good memories, especially of this week. For the rest of the guys, I just want them to practice hard and get better. And, you know, I don't know exactly how we played today. It didn't look great. And so there's always room to get better, and that's what I want them to do.
Well, regardless, this has been a very successful week for your team. What is the biggest takeaway from this week?
Biggest takeaway is we had the best week in the history of our program at this tournament. And these guys have to have confidence next year, and hopefully they have a taste of what it's like and will be hungrier next year than they were this year, and hopefully we can get it done.
Well, Coach, congratulations on a very successful season.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
And with LSU defeating USC, the Pac-12 falls to 0-4 versus SEC programs in NCAA match play since 2009, as once again it is an SEC school beating a Pac-12 school in match play. As LSU gets in line, they did it back in 2014, and Alabama, of course, in Arkansas with success in 2012 and 2009. All weekend long, Steve Rakowski has been a huge part of our broadcast as our college insider on the broadcast. He's joined now by Nota Begay, and I'm curious to hear both of your perspectives as LSU kind of comes out of nowhere, barely gets through the regional guys, but in the end, they're standing there as national champions.
Well, Ryan, when you think about what happened at the regionals a couple weeks ago at Yale, five teams from each of the six regional sites qualify for the championship here at the Concession Golf Club. And heading into that last day, they were in 10th place, 11 shots off the magic number. They rallied hard down the stretch, got the final spot by a single shot. So that's maybe somewhat of the surprising part that they were able to figure out Yale after 2 days of struggles. But in terms of coming out of nowhere, without question, no. That simple. LSU is really, really good. They won the SEC championship first time since 1987. And Nota, when you think about what LSU did in conferences, had a battle against at regionals, how much you think that helped them here when their backs were against the wall?
Well, it was so much about momentum, I think, because a team that was up against the wall, they fought their way back, dug themselves out of a hole, and felt like they had a new lease on life coming into this event, and then played so well to get into the match play portion, and then just felt like they were working on sort of borrowed time almost, in the sense they just went out, and they really executed, and they relied on a couple key players.